So there are four key benefits, and these benefits are what we've worked out over the last 5 or 6 years while we've been doing this. We started off with a defence growth partnership. We then moved into cross-sector innovation. We've done three challenges, and I'll sort of touch on those as I go through. But from a top level, the four key benefits, which everything sort of flows from when we do this, is engagement. It's not just engagement across defence. It's into the defence industry, it's into the wider industry, it's into academia. And it's that rich, diverse pool of talent, thought, and willingness to collaborate is where the real gems come from, as it were, around solutions to problems. And that's effectively what we're doing. We're looking for solutions to problems. We're not setting requirements, we set problem statements. And that allows us then to look at things, you know, what is the most effective way to bring this into service? Is in partnership, we develop things in partnership, can we deliver them in partnership? So that becomes very cost effective. We're able to understand the needs of a solution before we then set requirements or we look at requirements. We also identify that things aren't the way we thought they were. So we've been able to turn stuff off and terminate challenges really quickly as well. And that then brings in the whole cost avoidance aspect of the challenges as well. We've also found that the collaboration leads to partnerships. And off of the first cross-sector challenge we did, there was a lot of partnering going on with organisations which the Royal Navy didn't even know existed before we did the challenge. So the challenge brought new partners from industry into awareness of the Royal Navy who had solutions which were just as effective outside of the challenge as they were for the challenge we were running at the time as well. So those new partnerships and collaboration opportunities are really powerful and are a definite benefit of the cross-sector approach. And then you've got the knowledge and talent. It's like, we're a big organization, but there are types of talent in industry which is scarce. You know, there are specialisms, there are people who are in very small numbers around who knows what, and everybody would love to employ those people. This is a way of utilising that pool of talent, which is a scarce resource in the UK and also wider, to solve problems which would then benefit more than one organisation. And that's a key point for us. We know that there are companies out there which will pay a lot more than we can afford to pay people to tempt talent away. Part of our thinking with the cross-sector challenge is that we're giving something more than just a salary. We're giving people the ability to make a difference through the solutions which they identify or the way in which they construct these challenges. And that is just as attractive as that monthly salary. So that's a key thing around, you know, utilizing talent when it's needed and at the best time as well.